work at home in your own time if I want to work 10 hours or if I want to work 20 hours. But I enjoy it and lose track of time because the handpiece itself has been an enjoyment, really, because it's a hobby that turned art and turned into a money-making form, which I hadn't anticipated. Yeah, and hadn't planned on it going anywhere where along the lines it has went. Once I started making the eggs and the eggs took over, if anyone had told me that I would be making money on eggshells prior to it, I probably would have laughed. But as it's turned out, I do better on my eggs than I ever did on my glass. So I think it's finding where you do well at. When I had talked, well, a gentleman that I work with had said, why don't you come over, I want to show you my machine. So we went over there, my husband and I went to his house. I wrote my name in like you were using a pencil. There was no vibration, there was no heat. I was sold immediately. So I got a smaller outfit and then ended up going to a more expensive and expanded out to where I had the carrying case and whatever. So I'd probably say to anyone who was going to buy, get the whole outfit because you're eventually going to anyway. The transparencies are great. If you're not an artist and you use transparencies, you have them made bigger or smaller. I started out with an 8-inch octagon mirror. So I had the sizes, and probably by the time I got through, I had about 40 different articles done, and none of these I've asked for. They've led to speaking engagements. They've led to, when I'm not on the road, I'm working at home, but also I'm open to speaking engagements at that time. Plus, I'm open for business by appointment, which is another great thing because it gives me time to go and do the things I want to do. So I'm not tied down. I don't have anyone to answer to except my customers, which you try to take care of. But this all comes in my thanks to having a high-speed handpiece. As far as hours per day that I put in, sometimes I've carved, I would say an average of 8 to 12 hours a day. But remember, when I'm home, now I told you 22 shows plus a year. When you're home, you're busy. You're busy carving to get ready for the next show. I also get orders through the mail, and I ship my eggs all over the United States. I always wanted a Dremel until I had seen one of these. And a Dremel, yes, it's going to be less expensive, but it doesn't do the same work. So you're getting what you pay for. With the high speed, you can do so much more that if you try it, you're going to be convinced. And all I can say is, if you get a chance, try one. Now, if you're going to buy the handpiece, I want to bring this point up. If you're going to buy the handpiece and you're going to let it set, it's not going to make you any money. I work very hard, but it's something I enjoy doing. And you find what you enjoy. Maybe you want something to do in wood, or maybe you want to do on metal or gun stocks or glass, eggs, whatever it may be. Find out where you shine and what's the best for you. Many people have asked me to do gun stocks. I don't feel I'm capable. But it's where I enjoy is working with eggs. So I'm in the egg line. Maybe you would like doing something different. Maybe you want to work on there's automobiles, or if you're into cars, or if you into, there was one gentleman that went out and he got the logo of one of the high schools, and he would go over at break time, and he would set an hour a day up and made good money at it. It isn't my thing, but he did well at it. So it's what you enjoy doing and finding out where it's at. But if you let the tool sit, it's not going to make you money. You're not going to get rich. It's not get rich quick. Nothing is if you don't put a little effort and work into it. I started doing 3 years ago last February. It'll be 4 years this coming February. had my first show in May, which was an art and craft show. Had made more off the eggshells than I had off stained glass or anything else I'd ever done, which I'd been done a lot of different crafts. I'd been into ceramics and stained glass paintings. But the eggs brought me more satisfaction and more pride. I don't care if the people are young or old or rich or poor, they're all interested because it's something different. Each one of mine are uniquely different because I never copy another one. I never make two alike or try to make two alike. Once I've made one, I set it aside and never look back at it. So if it sounds like I'm proud of my eggs, I am. They've taken me to California, Phoenix, Arizona, Dallas, Texas, Corning, New York, where they were on display not far from the, or in the same building as a Steuben Glass. Allentown, Pennsylvania, Dearborn, Michigan, and I do an average of 22 to 23 shows a year. Everything has been a result. Each show brings something new and different. So yeah, I guess at my age I'm really proud that the handpiece has really done this for me, because without it I couldn't have done it. And I still don't think I could. There's people who do eggs and use a pair of scissors, and I don't know how they do it. But I'll take the credit for the designs, but I couldn't do the designs without a high-speed handpiece.